Thank you, Father Venters, and welcome everyone to the 136th annual Fancy Farm Picnic. First in this corner, please welcome the Republicans. And in this corner, please welcome the Democrats. And finally, we have to welcome the most important people of all, the Democrats who vote Republican every November.
I said, blue moon of Kentucky, keep on a shining. Shine on the one that's gone and left me blue. Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on a shining. Shine on the one that's gone.
This is the last event in America where people from both parties line up and mix it up and get yelled at by supporters from the other side, and they have to stand and deliver.
One of my proudest moments is when I looked at Barack Obama in the eye and I said, Mr. President, you will not fill this Supreme Court vacancy.
The Clintons are to corruption what Capone was to crime.
Lock her up! Lock her up! Lock her up!
Oh, it can be very raucous. Sometimes you can't hear the speaker. I mean, the crowd gets so into it that speakers don't have a chance.
Who are you? Who are you?
Y'all can cuss me all you want. I don't care. It's real simple. I'm the one that was standing there defending your right to say just that.
When we were growing up around here, this was the Democratic stronghold of the Kentucky. The first congressional district was totally solid Democrat. In Fancy Farm, you could find five people, maybe, that were Republicans.
It used to be the Rock of Gibraltar of the Democratic Party. 30 years ago, they would say you could hold a Republican meeting in a phone booth.
Why are you a Democrat, Roy Jones?
Born and raised a Democrat. The Republicans can't sway my mind. I've been Daddy would call a yellow dog Democrat.
I would vote
for a yellow dog before I would a Republican.
As Democrats, we're beat to death with guns and gays and God all the time. But what they don't understand is, if Jesus was walking the earth right now, he would be a Democrat.
Benghazi lives matter! Benghazi lives matter! Benghazi lives matter!
It has changed 180 degrees. We only have two Democratic leaders, the Attorney General and the Secretary of State, that are Democrat. Everybody else is Republican.
The state's top Democrat, Andy Beshear, isn't here today because he's busy investigating. I'll tell you what he needs to investigate. What the heck happened to the Kentucky Democrat Party?
Well, it's not your grandpa's Democratic Party anymore,
no.
Which is what we all were.
That's
what we called Southern Democrats. Jerry is still diehard Democrat because he was a union man his whole life, and so was my dad, and I was in the union with him for many years.
And so was my dad, union man.
And that's the reason.
These boys have changed. They got up and got them the good jobs, made up before they got the good living out. Now they don't back us anymore.
The sun shines bright here in my old Kentucky home.
The strength of the Democratic Party in Western Kentucky was built in the years of Roosevelt because the federal government helped the area develop. The Tennessee Valley Authority came in and provided electricity that private enterprise couldn't afford. Farmers got help with some programs. It wasn't really a giveaway, it was a helping hand. And that's how the Democratic Party built.
Far away.
I was raised a staunch Democrat, but a conservative Democrat. I'm still registered Democrat, but we are so conservative, we kind of look Republican.
Jimmy Carter is the only Democratic president I've ever voted for. I learned my lesson after that. And then when I went door to door in 2012, you would not believe how many people said, I didn't leave the Democratic Party, Democratic Party left me.
You probably can't read this, but this little sticker says, God bless America. That would be politically incorrect in the Democratic Party. I mean, it's just, they're so over the top.
My turn, Governor! My turn, Governor!
The
If you want the Judeo-Christian principles this nation was built on, if you want your Second Amendment rights, then I ask for you to elect conservatives this November.
The economy's the best it's been in years. The stock market's the highest ever been. Gas $1.89, and these people still want to vote for somebody like Rand Paul.
How doth Hillary hate us? Let me count the ways.
Sometimes I think all these people need to go have themselves checked out. Yeah. I think mentally they've gone on unbalanced.
Right, I knew
there.
That was going to come out of his mouth.
The Democratic Party has gone away from what a lot of Kentuckians are like. The idea of a working class Democrat, they've stopped reaching out to those people. They've stopped talking their language, and it's turned a lot of people off.
How's it going, guys?
I'm probably more of a, I don't, if there's even a term, a liberal Republican, possibly. I do have some liberal tendencies, and I have a lot of the values that maybe some conservative Democrats have. But that's just, that animal doesn't exist anymore in Western Kentucky.
Fabula asked for $6.
You know, it's tough to not be a conservative Republican in this district. It, you know, it's just the way people are thinking now. So if you want to get ahead in business, if you want to get ahead in your personal life, and if you want things to happen in your community, you're going to have to get behind those folks that that are going to win the elections.
Well, it was on a moonlit night, stars shining bright, whispering on high, your lover said goodbye. I said blue moon.
Dude, there was never a Republican in the courthouse on the fiscal court in Graves County until 6 years ago when I ran.
And I voted for him, too. The first time I ever voted for a Republican.
That's the first time he's admitted it.
Only reason I had to do that was a nephew. I had to vote.
Left me